Ryan.
Welcome, folks. This is Tom O'Brien of TFNN. We go 5 days a week. We go 7.5 hours a day. We go 24 hours a day on the internet at TFNN.com. Always remember, folks, whatever you think about, you bring about. Whatever you focus on grows. Hope everyone's having a great day, safe day. Let's make it a great night, folks. Cultivate wisdom. You don't need to accumulate knowledge to become wise. Anyone can become wise. When you become wise, you respect your mind, you respect your soul, and you respect your body. When you become wise, your life is controlled by your heart, not your head. Market wise, let's take a look at it out here. We have the Dow Industrials trading up 688. NASDAQ is up 341. S&P's up 84. That's a gain out here in the NASDAQ of 3.1%. Inside the S&P's 2.5 and 2.5 in the Dow Industrials. Gold. Gold contract trading up $13.90. At $19.57 an ounce. You have silver up 22 cents, $27.21 an ounce. Light sweet crude up $1.25, $38.01 a barrel. Notes and bonds. We have the 10-year right now down 4 ticks, trading out at 139.08. The 30-year down 23 at 175.18 in King Dollar. King Dollar's down 185 ticks, trading 93.260. The euro is at 118. The yen is at 106.22, and the British pound's at 129 to one U.S. dollar. Our phone number is 877-927-6648. Give us a call, folks. Want to know what's going on in your world, in the world of the S&Ps. Let's take a look at them. What do we got? Well, you got a heck of a bounce. There's no doubt about it. The bottom line is that, once again, it looks like we have a 24-hour market on the way down. That being said, what we haven't done out here yet inside, well, the S&Ps, this is quite a run in the S&Ps. There's no two ways about it. You take a look at this. The highs of yesterday, overnight yesterday, was at 34.47. If we take a look at where we basically opened up yesterday, the bottom line is that you are higher than the where we were at the open yesterday. That being said, if we go over and we take a look at the SPY, the real kicker here, folks, is going to be how do we close? The reason that I'm saying that is this, is that the gap on the SPY is 342.25. Well, we're at 342.19. We hit 342.23. So if this is just a close of a gap and you back down, what you're going to see is this. When you have an ABC structure in the making, an ABC structure, folks, is two straight line moves. The first one, bottom line, in this particular case, you've come down. You started out at 358. You get down yesterday to 332. You come down with volume. You bounce with light volume, which we have right now in a monster way. The real kicker is going to be, how do we close? The reason I'm saying how do you close, because what we haven't done yet, we just missed it, is the highs of yesterday. If this backs off at all, then your probability starts getting a little bit higher. If it doesn't back off, that is telling me that the S&P, the SPY, wants to basically, not still, even the lows of, you could run to 347. See, the 342.59, this gets kind of intriguing, actually, looking at it. The 342.59 is the low of the initial downdraft. NDX 100, let's go take a look at the NDX. So the NDX is still weaker than the SPY out here today. What you have with the NDX is that we're up $9.33 right now. You're at 279.27. Bottom line, that if in fact it closes over like the 278.22, which is $1.10 higher than we are, then it could actually run into this 284. You close underneath it, and then let me bring this up. NQ, we're going to bring up the NQ futures so you can see how these babies are shaking out also. Inside the futures, what you have is that we got up into this 11,478, couldn't handle it. You had the first little rundown. The first little rundown came back to the strength that was established out here at 11 o'clock this morning. That being said, we go into the three Qs. We take a look at the three Qs, and what you're going to have is that you're going up with 51 million. You basically, you came down with just a monster. You came down with 110 million as well as 123 million. So the real kicker here is going to be, how do you finish off? Because if, in fact, this Q just comes down 1 point, that would be a failure on price and volume. Right now, what you have inside the marketplace is you're bouncing on light volume, but we've been doing that for a long period of time. You fail on price, too, it's going to make a difference big time. Gold market, GDX. Let's go take a look at the GDX, because what we have had out here is this. The gold market, folks, didn't pull back. Well, it pulled back to a lower part of its consolidation, but it did not get smoked as the market got smoked on the way down the last 3 days. What you have here is that you got some real juice inside of this market. And it looks like to me that this thing is ready. The equities, this is, the equities are ready to run for their highs once again. We get the GDX up $1.73. That high that looks like it wants to go after is 45.78. We go take a look at Barrick Gold. Barrick Gold right now, that is trading. Yeah, it's picking its nose up in a big way. That's up $1.25. You get 16 million shares traded. You get a high volume high laying out at 31.22. That wants to go for it. We take a look at Agnico Eagle. Agnico Eagle, same setup. You're up 3.54. The top of this consolidation is at 84.66. Right now, you're at 82.77. And then if we go over to King Dollar, the thing with King Dollar, which is pretty wild, is that once again, it just couldn't handle price. You know, we got first time we got over the swing point was yesterday. The small swing was 93.473. Got over it. It was the first time. And, oh my God, look at this. This is crazy. That I get this back 6 months. It's the first time since 102.95 that it could even get over a swing point. That being said, guess what? In spades, gave it up again today. So, bottom line, we'll see where this baby is going to shake out. But, and the correlation is kind of interesting. Tommy and I were talking about this morning, is that is the correlation so tight that, you know, the dollar had like a three-day bounce? Does the broad market can't stand that bounce in the dollar that dramatic that we start pulling back in the dollar again and the market can go forward? Well, we'll see how this shakes out. And next week and a half to see if that correlation is there. Dow Industrials right now up 669, Nasdaq's up 331, S&Ps are up 82, we got gold up 14, silver up 23 cents. Stay right there, folks. Come right back.